Welcome, student. Start with the special sense eye. 70% of all sensory receptors in the eyes. Each eye has over a million nerve fibers. Protection from the eye. Most of the eye is enclosed in a bony orbit. A cushion of fat surrounds most of the eye. Accessory structure of the eye. The accessory structure of the eye, which include the eyelids, eyelashes, eyebrows, the lacrimal apparatus, and the extrinsic eye muscle. Lacrimal apparatus, it means the tear producing apparatus. First one is the eyelids. The upper and the lower eyelids or palpebrae, which is singular, shade the eyes during the sleep, which protect the eyes from excessive light and foraging object, and spread the lubricating secretion over the eyeballs. The space between the upper and the lower eyelids that exposes the eyeball is the palpebral fissure. Its angle are known as the lateral commissure, which is narrower and closer to the temporal bone, and the medial commissure, which is broader and nearer to the nasal bone. In the medial commissure is a small reddish elevation, the lacrimal caruncle, which contains the sebaceous or the oil gland and sudoriferous or the sudorum. The whitish material that sometimes collects in the medial commissure comes from this gland. Eyelashes and the eyebrows. The eyelashes, which project from the border of the each eyelid, and the eyebrows, which are transversely above the upper eyelids, help to protect the eyeballs from the foraging object, perspiration, and the direct rays of the sun. Sebaceous gland at the base of the hair follicle of the eyelashes, which is called as the sebaceous ciliary gland, releases a lubricating fluid into the follicles. Infection of this gland, usually by bacteria, they cause a painful pus-filled swelling, which is called as the stap. These are the eyelashes, these are the eyebrows, these are the upper eyelids, lower eyelids, and these are the palpebral fissure, and these are the lateral commissure, these are the medial commissure, lacrimal caruncle, flows of the tear, in that the lacrimal gland secrete the tears into lacrimal duct, which distribute tears over surface of the eyeball. Superior or inferior lacrimal canaliculi drain tears into lacrimal sac, which drain tear into nasolacrimal duct, which drains tear into the nasal cavity. Now, extrinsic eye muscle. The eye is seated in the bony depression of the skull, which is called as the orbits, and the orbit helps protect the eyes, stabilize them in the three-dimensional space, and anchor them to the muscle that produce the essential movement. The extrinsic eye muscle extend from the walls of the bony orbit to the sclera, which is a white portion of the eye, and are surrounded in the orbit by a significant quantity of the periorbital fat. These muscles are capable of moving the eye in almost any direction. Next one is the anatomy of the eyeball. The adult eyeball measures about 2.5 cm, which is a 1 inch in diameter, of its total surface area. Only the anterior 1/6 is exposed. The remainder is recessed and protected by the orbit into which it fits. Anatomically, the wall of the eyeball consists of the three layers. First one is the fibrous tunic. Second one is the vascular tunic, and last one is the retina, which is the inner tunic. Fibrous tunic. The fibrous tunic is the superficial layer of the eyeball, and which is consist of the cornea and the sclera. Cornea is anterior and the sclera is the posterior. Next one is the cornea. It is a transparent coat that covers the color iris. Because it is cover the cornea, helps to focus light onto the retina. Its outer surface consists of non-keratinized stratified squamous epithelium, and the middle coat of the cornea, which is consist of collagen fiber, fibroblast, and the inner surface is simple squamous epithelium. Since the central part of the cornea receives the oxygen from the outer side air, contact lenses that are worn for long periods of the time must be permeable to permit oxygen to pass through them. Next one is the sclera. Sclera is the heart. The sclera, the white of the eye, is a layer of dense connective tissue which is made up of mostly of the collagen fiber and the fibroblast. The sclera covers the entire eyeball except the cornea. It gives sharp to the eyeball, makes it more rigid, protects its inner part, and serves as a site of attachment for the extrinsic eye muscle. At the junction of the sclera and the cornea is an opening known as the scleral venous sinus, a fluid which is called as the aqueous humor, which will be described later, drains into this sinus. Next one is the vascular tunic. A vascular tunic or the uvea is the middle layer of the eyeball, and which is composed of the three parts, choroid, ciliary body, and the iris. Choroid. This choroid is a highly vascular choroid, which is the posterior portion of the vascular tunic, lines most of the internal surface of the sclera, and its numerous blood vessel provides the nutrients to the posterior surface of the retina. The choroid also contains melanocyte that produces the pigment of the melanin, which cause this layer to appear the dark brown in color. Melanin in the choroid absorb the stray light rays, which prevent the reflection and scattering of the light within the eyeball. As a result, the image cast on the retina by the cornea and lens remains sharp and clear. Next is the ciliary body. In the anterior portion of the vascular tunic, the choroid becomes the ciliary body. It extends from the ora serrata, the jaw anterior margin of the retina, to a point just posterior to the junction of the sclera and the cornea. Like the choroid, the ciliary body appears dark in color because it contains the melanin-producing melanocyte. In addition, the ciliary body consists of the ciliary process and the ciliary muscle. The ciliary process are the protrusion or the folds on the internal surface of the ciliary body. The ciliary muscle is a circular band of smooth muscle. Contraction or relaxation of the ciliary muscle changes the tightness of the zonular fibers, which alters the shape of the lens, adapting it for near or the far the region. Next one is the iris. The iris or the rainbow, the color portion of the eyes, is shaped like a flattened donut. It is surrounded between the cornea and the lens and is attached at its outer margin to the ciliary process. It consists of melanocyte and circular and the radial smooth muscle fiber. The amount of the melanin in the iris determines the eye color. The eyes appear brown to black when its iris contains a large amount of melanin, blue when its melanin concentration is very low, and green when its melanin concentration is moderate. Next one is the pupil. A principal function of the iris is to regulate the amount of light entering the eyeball through the pupil. Pupil, which is a little person, because this is where you see a reflection of yourself when looking into someone's eyes. The hole in the center of the iris. The pupil appears black because as you look through the lens, you see the heavily pigmented back of the eyes, which is a choroid and the retina. However, if bright light is directed into the pupil, the reflect light is red because of the blood vessel on the surface of the retina. It is for this reason that a person's eye appear red in the photograph when the flash is directed into the pupil. Next one is the retina. The third and the inner layer of the eyeball is the retina. Lines the posterior three quarters of the eyeball and is the beginning of the visual pathway. The retina, which is consist of a pigmented layer and a neural layer. The pigmented layer is a sheet of melanin containing epithelial cells, which is located between the choroid and the neural part of the retina. The melanin in the pigmented layer of the retina, as in the choroid, also helps to absorb the stray light rays. The neural or the sensory layer of the retina is multi-layered outgrowth of the brain that process visual data extensively before sending nerve impulses into the axon that form the optic nerve. Three distinct layers of the retinal neurons, which is a photoreceptor layer, the bipolar cell layer, and the ganglionic cell layer, are separated by the two zones, the outer and the inner synaptic layers, where the synaptic contacts are made. The photoreceptor are the specialized cell in the photoreceptor layer that begin in the process by which light rays are ultimately converted to the nerve impulses. There are the two types of the photoreceptor, rods and the cones. Each retina has about 6 million of the cones and 120 million of the rods. Rods allow us to see in the dim light, such as the moonlight. Because rods do not provide color vision, in the dim light we can see only the black, white and all shades of the gray in between. Brighter light stimulate the cones, which produces the color vision. Three types of the cones are present in the retina. First one is the blue cones, which are sensitive to the blue light. Second one is the green cones, which are sensitive to the green light. And third one is the red cones, which are sensitive to the red light. Color vision results from the stimulation of various combination of these three types of the cones. Most of our experiences are mediated by the cone system, the loss of which produces the legal blindness. A person who loses road vision mainly has difficulty seeing in the dim light, and those who should not drive at the night. From photoreceptor, information flows through the outer synaptic layer of the bipolar cells and from the bipolar cell through the inner synaptic layer to the ganglionic cell. The axon of the ganglionic cell extend posteriorly to the optic disc and exit the eyeball as the optic nerve. The optic disc is also called as the blind spot because it contains no rods or the cones. We cannot see the image that strikes the blind spot. These are the photoreceptor, outer synaptic layer, bipolar layer, inner layer, and the ganglionic layer. These are the microscopic anatomy of the retina. Next one is the lens. Behind the pupil and the iris, within the cavity of the eyeball, is the lens. Within the cell of the lens, proteins, which is called as the crystallines, arranged like the layers of an onion, make up the refractive media of the lens, which normally is perfectly transparent and lacks blood vessel. It is enclosed by a clear connective tissue capsule and held in position by encircling zonular fiber which attach to the ciliary process. The lens help to focus image on the retina to facilitate the clear vision. Now next one is the interior of the eyeball. The lens divided into the anterior of the eyeball into the two cavities, the anterior and the vitreous cavity. Anterior cavity, the space anterior to the lens, which is consist of the two chamber. The anterior chamber lies between the cornea and the iris. The posterior chamber lies behind the iris and in front of the zonular fibers and the lens. Both chamber of the anterior cavity are filled with the aqueous humor, a transparent watery fluid that nourishes the lens and the cornea. Aqueous humor continually filter out of blood capillaries in the ciliary process of the ciliary body and enters the posterior chamber. It then flows forward between the iris and the lens through the pupil and into the anterior chamber. From the anterior chamber, aqueous humor drains into the scleral venous sinus and then into the blood. Normally, this aqueous humor is completely replaced about every 90 minutes. The larger posterior cavity of the eyeball is the vitreous chamber, which lies between the lens and the retina. Within the vitreous chamber is the vitreous body, which is a transparent jelly-like substance that holds the retina, flushes against the choroid, given the retina an even surface for the reception of a clear image. It occupies about 4/5 of the eyeball. Unlike the aqueous humor, the vitreous body does not undergo the constant replacement. It is formed during the embryonic life and consists of mostly water plus collagen fibers. The vitreous body also contains the phagocytic cells that remove the debris, keeping this part of the eye clear for the unobstructive vision. These are the summary of the structure of the eyeball. They contain the fiber tunica, in that the cornea and the sclera, vascular tunica, iris, ciliary body and the choroid, retina, lens, anterior cavity and the vitreous chamber. These are the structure of the eye. They contain the cornea, pupil, iris, lens, retina, choroid, sclera, physiology of the vision. Physiological events of the vision, which is consist of the following parts. First one is the refraction of light entering the eye. Second one is focusing of image onto the retina by accommodation of the lens. Convergence of image, photochemical activities in retina and conversion into the neuronal impulses, processing in brain and the perception. First one is the refraction of light entering the eye. Light wave travel parallel to each other, but they bend when passes from one medium to the another medium. This phenomenon, which is called as the refraction. Before light reaches the retina, it passes through the cornea, aqueous humor, lens, vitreous humor. So refraction takes place in every medium before it falls on the retina. In normal eye, light wave focus on retina. However, in myopic eye, it means the short sightedness, light focus into the front of the retina. So this defect can be treated by using the concave lens. In case of far sightedness, light focus behind retina, so no image is formed. This defect can be treated by using convex lens. Second one is the accommodation of lens to the focus image. The accommodation is a reflex process to bring light rays from object into the perfect focus on retina by adjusting the lens. When an object lying less than 6 meters away is viewed, image form behind the retina. But due to the accommodation of the lens, image form in retina and we can see the object. For the accommodation to view closer object, ciliary muscle contract and lens become thick, which cause the focus on the closer object. Similarly, when the distance object is viewed, ciliary muscle get relaxed, so the tension of the ligament become greater, which pull the lens, and lens become thinner, due to which image form on retina. The normal eye is able to accommodate light from object about 25 cm to the infinity. Focus on the nearer object, in that the ciliary muscle get contract, the ciliary body pull forward and the inward, tension on the suspensory ligament of the lens get reduces, lens become thicker and round due to the elasticity, possible to focus near the object. Now focus on the distance object, ciliary muscle get relaxed, ciliary body return to its normal resting state, tension on the suspensory ligament of the lens increases and lens become thinner and the flat. Again the possible to the focus distance get object. These are the for distance of the object and these are the nearer to the object. Next one is the convergence of image. Human eye have a biconcave vision. It means although we have two eye, we perceive single image. In biconcave vision, two eyeball turn slightly inward to focus a close object so that both the image falls on corresponding points on retina at the same time. This phenomenon is called as the convergence. Fourth one is the photochemical activities in the retina and conversion into the neuronal impulses. In that first one is the photochemical activity in the rods. Each eye contains 125 million of the rods which are located in the neuroretina. The rods contains light sensitive pigment rhodopsin, and this rhodopsin is a molecule formed by the combination of a protein scotopsin and a light sensitive small molecule which is the retina. The retinal is a carotenoid molecule and is derived from a vitamin A, which is retinol. This retinal exists in the two isomeric form, cis and the trans, according to light condition. The extracellular fluid surrounding rod cells, which contains the high concentration of sodium ion and low concentration of the potassium ions, while concentration of sodium is low and potassium is high inside the rod cells. The concentration is maintained by the sodium and the potassium pump. In resting phase, potassium tends to move outside the rod cells, creating the slightly negative charges inside the cell. When light is fall on the rod cells, it is absorbed by rhodopsin and it breaks into the scotopsin and 11 cis retinal, and this process is known as the bleaching. This 11 cis retinal absorb the photon of light and change into all trans retinal, which in turn activates the scotopsin into the enzyme. This reaction produces large amount of transducin, which activates another enzyme, which is a phosphodiesterase. This phosphodiesterase hydroxylates cyclic AMP, which causes to keep the flow of the sodium ion inside the rod cell. This causes increase the negative charges inside the cell, creating the hyperpolarized state. And this hyperpolarized rod cell transmit the neuronal signal to the bipolar cells. And this bipolar cell, amersing cell and the ganglionic cell process the neuronal signal and generate action potential to transmit to the brain via the optic nerve. In that the rhodopsin absorb the light, they cutting the G protein transduction to exchange the GDP with the GTP, and the activated transduction subunit splits away and they activate the PD or the phosphodiesterase. And this activated phosphodiesterase hydrolyze the cyclic AMP to the 5 GMP, which causing the sodium channel to get the clothes. Next one is the photochemical activities in the cones. Each eye, which contains the 7 million of the cone cells, the neuronal activity in the cone cell is similar to that of the rod cell, but there are 3 different types of the cone cells and each cone cell contains the different photopigment and are sensitive to the red, green and the blue color. Like the rod cone cell contains iodopsin are the photopigment which is composed of 11 cis retinal and the photopsin. The perception of color depends upon which cone are stimulated. The final perceived color is combined of all three types of the cone cell which is stimulated depending upon the level of the stimulation. The proper mix of all three colors produces the perception of white and absence of all color produces the perception of the black. Fifth one is the processing of image in brain and the perception. All visual information originates in the retina due to the stimulation of the rod and the cones are conveyed to the brain. The retina contains the 5 types of the cell and they are interconnected by the synapses. These cells are the photoreceptor cells, which is a bipolar cell, ganglionic cell, horizontal cell and the amaranic cells. The photoreceptor cell, bipolar cell and the ganglionic cell transmit the impulse directly from the retina to the brain. And the nerve fiber of the ganglion cell from both the eyes carries the impulses along the 2 optic nerve. The optic nerve meets at the optic chiasma, where fibers from the nasal half of each retina cross over, but fibers from temporal half of each retina do not cross over. The optic nerve after the crossing the chiasma, which is called as the optic tract, and each optic tract continues posteriorly until it synapses with the neuron in the thalamus, which is called as the lateral geniculate body, which project to the primary visual cortex in occipital lobe of cerebrum and image is perceived. In that the shot, light rays is falling on the retina, visual receptor that is rod and cones are stimulated, impulses pass via optic nerve, optic chiasma, optic tract, relay in related geniculate body, a nucleus of the thalamus. Fibers go to the superior colliculus, prelateral area, example for the pupillary reflexes, that is light and accumulation reflex. Optic radiation, fibers terminate to primary visual area, 17 of occipital cortex, where true image of the object is formed and the neuronal signal passed to the visual association area, 18. For recognition and the interpretation of the visualized object. These are the eye and the physiology of the vision. Thank you.